If you've seen our tattoo exhibition and you liked how we created this virtual space where anyone can just walk through and click on various images and launch videos even, and you're wondering maybe how you if you can use this for your class to create a module for students to have this sort of like more interactive experience, the answer is it's really, really easy. And so in this video, I'm going to just show you how we created this virtual space. And there are two ways to do it. One is to make to use this free program which we use called Make VT. And the other way is actually to use H5P. So in H5P, the module has to be on Moodle, whereas the pro of using Make VT is that it can be you can just share a link or you can embed this link in any website. So I'll show you how to do this, and then maybe I'll make another video on how to use H5P later on. So I already have I'm logged into my account on this thing, and it's totally free. So all you need to do is create a new tour. And you'll see that we can do one very quickly in just a few steps. So the first step will be, well, you can name your tour. I'll just leave it as virtual tour. There are three types of images basically that you can upload. So if you have a 360 cam or images or video that's been taken with 360 cam, you can upload it here. But I don't have a 360 cam. So for the tattoo exhibition, we actually used flat images. So just a normal, ordinary image. So I have two images that I'll use today. So in the tattoo exhibition, we started with this panoramic image, and then I had a close up. So basically what I wanted people to do was to start here and then be able to move forward down this corridor and end up here. So I'm going to just take both of these images and drop it here. You can just upload if you have them on file as well, and then they will very quickly upload here. Okay, and then the next thing you want to do is, step three, it says here, is to create links between the panoramas. So basically you want to tell the software to move people from here to here, right? So we're going to go to the hotspot editor, and you'll see your images here. So click on the first image first, okay? And you can see that it's already sort of like you can zoom in and scroll here and there. So I want to have a hotspot here, a button here, where if somebody presses it, then they can move down further down this corridor into the next image. So I'll just press this and just click somewhere where you think the hotspot should go, like there. And choose an icon. And then here you want to choose transition. So there are many things that can happen when someone clicks on a button. So for right now, we want them to transition to the next image. And then you just choose what is the next image you want them to transition to, and move this eye thing, and then hit save. And so now you can see that there's this icon here for that is clickable. Okay, so now I'm gonna go to the second image, and I want to insert a video here. So I want it so that if somebody comes into this corridor and they look at this board, they'll be able to click on it and it'll launch a video. So this time I'm gonna choose this icon and YouTube. So I already have my YouTube video all keyed up here. So you just need to copy the link and insert it here and then click save. Okay, so you can see that the icon immediately shows up here. So this is basically done. I've put two hotspots and I'm happy with that. So the next thing you wanna do is just go to your tour settings and just make sure that you select the first image that you want everyone to land on. So this is the first image and I'm happy with that. And then we're gonna go to view, share and export. Publish and view the tour, and voila. So this is just a preview of our tour. It will take a couple days to actually load, but you can preview it right away already. You can see that this is my hotspot, and it's coming to this corridor where I want it to go. And here's my video, and there you go. So yeah, that's basically all that you need to do to make a virtual tour like this using this program. It's basically the same process to make it in H5P, and I really recommend that if it's for students anyway, it's going to be on Moodle, then you should use H5P because I think it's just more reliable of a program to use. But I hope this video has been helpful, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask. And if you haven't checked out our tattoo exhibition yet, please go and check it out. There are so many interesting stories to hear.